Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. I hope you all are doing absolutely well. So guys, this video is going to be very helpful for all those associates who are willing to upgrade their level from Ninja to Digital. Okay, so in this video we are going to talk about Elevate Wings 1 procedure, what all are the common doubts that the candidates have while registering for it, and we are also going to see how can you register for May cycle. And this is the last chance for you to register for May cycles, as the registrations are going to be closed by day after tomorrow. So let's see the complete details that you need to know about Elevate Wings 1. So first of all, I'm going to explain you what all are the main important things that you need to know in order to apply for it, and after that I'm also going to take you to the registration page and I will show you which option should you select in the registration process so that you will get easily clear the exam. So let's talk about the eligibility first of all. So associates in grade 1 or below, that is grade C1 or below. So C1, if you have C1 grade, then you are eligible for it. If you have any grade below C1, like C1Y or Y or any other grade, then also you are eligible for it. Now there is a common doubt that I am getting, like you have joined the company before 2 months and your grade is C1, are you eligible for it? Yes, you are eligible for it if your grade is C1. Next is, you should be a full-time TCS employee. You should not be on notice period. You should not be an intern. So if you are a full-time TCS employee, then you are eligible for this Wings 1. Next is this dashboard. So this is very important in order to understand which exams you need to clear in the two steps or two tracks, as we say it. So this dashboard you will find in iEvolve ADC compliance, and when you click on view, then you can see this dashboard. Okay, so there are basically two steps in this journey, wherein in step one you can take either of these three exams. So first one is the core programming tech, second is core full stack, third is UE external certification. Now let's talk about UE external certification first of all. So in this there is a list of certifications that the unit TDs have given. If you have done any certification from that list, what you need to do is you just need to upload your certification in the iEvolve, and once it gets approved, this step will be marked as completed. Okay, but just in case if you have not done UE external certification, then at this point of time you can only apply for core programming tech or core full stack tech. So now in a minute we are going to see what all are these core programming tech and core full stack tech. So this is the step one. Once you have registered for step one, you should also register for step two. Now in step two, you can register for multiple options. You are having some non-technical tracks like articulation, business, process. And again, the ones which we already had in step one, we also have the same in step two also. That is core full stack, unit programming and unit elective. So now there are some restrictions that you need to keep in mind before applying. So pass status consider only for full stack at step 2. Now suppose if you have appeared for core full stack in step 1, then if you are again appearing for core full stack in step 2, then in step 1 you have to get a distinction and in step 2 you have to get a pass. Okay, so which means, what is meant by distinction? Distinction means that you should have above 75% and pass means you should have 55+. Okay, so both step 1 and step 2 can't have core programming tag to achieve digital. So you cannot select core programming tag in both the steps. Suppose if you have selected core programming tag in step 1, you have to select anything else from the remaining options in step 2. Third point is, both step 1 and step 2 can't have unit electives to achieve digital. So for example, if you have uploaded your certification in step 1 and it is your step 1 is cleared, then you cannot apply for unit elective in step 2. So these are some of the important points that you need to keep in mind before registering. Now this page, that is Digital Milestone, explains the same thing which I have explained using the dashboard just now. So here also it is mentioned that two track completion, you have two tracks, that is the first track and second track. First track should be a technical with distinction, that is if you have selected core full stack or core programming or unit identified proctor technical external certification, you should get a distinction in step 1. Distinction means above 70% of marks. Next is, in second track, if you have selected any non-tech, then you should have distinction. Non-tech means if you have selected business, process or articulation, then you should have distinction in them. If you have selected unit elective or programming, then also you should get a distinction in them. Just in case if you have selected core full stack in step 2 and step 1 also, then in step 1 you should have distinction and in step 2 you can have a pass. Okay, So we should not dive deep into this one because we have already understood all the things using this dashboard. So I'm going to move ahead and show you this list of certifications that are eligible. So these are the certifications that are eligible for Wings Journey. But right now it is very late. If you have not done the certification, you cannot apply for these certifications and get it approved at this point of time. So you should go either the other ways, which are learning tracks. Okay. Moving ahead. What is meant by passing and distinction? So I have already explained, passing means greater than or equals to 55%. Distinction means greater than or equals to 70%. Ways to complete tracks. So there are different ways to complete tracks. So for example, in core programming tech, if you have selected for Python, okay, then you do not have to do anything in core programming track. But if you have selected core full stack track, then there are three ways to complete the tracks. First is you need to complete the course in iEvolve. Okay. Second step is if you do not have time, then what you can do is you can give the exit assessment. So in every course there are exit assessments, so you can directly give them. But the third option is if you do not have time to take the course or give the assessment, you do not have time for that. What you can do is you can self declare the competency. Self declaring the competency means that you already have the knowledge about that particular technology or course, but you do not have time right now to attend the course. So what you are doing is you are self declaring the competency. So there is a way of self declaring the competency. I have already explained in the previous video. Make sure to check that. Now next is core full stack tracks. In core full stack track, we have different tracks like T1, T2 and so on. So you can select any tracks according to your choice. And what you need to do is either you need to complete the course in iEvolve, otherwise you need to self declare the competency. This is very important, guys, because what most of the candidates do is they just register for the exam, but they do not complete the course or they do not self declare the competency. And because of this, they do not get the exam mail or the admit card to attend the exam. So make sure that you self declare the competency just in case if you have not yet completed the course. Now in core programming tracks, we have different tracks. So you can see that there are 1 to 15 tracks available and you can appear for any track. Now in core programming track, there is no prerequisite that you need to complete any course or you need to declare the self competency. There is nothing like that. You just need to attend, register for it, and you just directly need to attend the exam. In exam, you will be having around 15 to 20 MCQs and one coding question. Next is business skill. So business skill is a non-technical track in which you have two options. You can select only one out of two, that is business skill 1 or business skill 2. Next is articulation track. So in articulation, we have different tracks that you need to complete. If you do not have time to complete the articulation tracks, you can self-declare the competency and directly appear for the exam. Moving ahead, in process, we have two tracks. So in process also, we have the same scenario wherein you just do not need to appear for the entire course, you can directly self declare the competency. I'm also going to show you how can you self declare the competency and where can you get the IDs for self declaring the competencies. So there are different cycles that happens. So first cycle of this year is going to happen in May, for which the registrations are currently going on and you need to register as soon as possible. Next exam cycles are going to be in August and November. So let's move ahead and go to our registration page and let's see how can we register for it. So this is the registration link. You will get it in the Nomi. When you will search for Wings One community, that is this one, Elevate Communications, you will get this registration survey. So in registration survey, the complete details are given. We are going to look at the most important ones. First of all, registration closer date is 30th of April, 5 p.m. Indian Standard Time, which is very close. That is in 2 days you are going to have the last day. Next is learning completion closing date is also 30th of April and unit external certification date is 31st May, 5 p.m. So next thing to know is, so this is the most important part. That is the eligibility criteria. You will be eligible to appear for the proctored assessment upon completing the learning prerequisites in iEvolve on or before 30th of April, provided you have high performance band. Now, so many candidates have this doubt that we have C band. So C band is not eligible to appear for Wings One. So if you have your band as A or B, then you only you are eligible. Just in case if you have not got your band due to any reason, either it is your first year in the company or you are unallocated or any reason, if you do not have your band and if you have your rating, then your rating will be considered. That is, you should have 4 or 5 rating. If you do not have your band and rating both, then for the in that case you will be considered the learning prerequisite. That is, either you should complete the courses in iEvolve or you should self declare the competency for the given particular exam. So these are the eligibility criteria in order to attend the exam. Okay, now let's see some of the important points. So the exams will be happen in person. That is, you need to go to your depute branch, okay, and your ID card is mandatory for it. And the most important thing is, if you have your laptop, then you can select in the registration survey. If you do not have it, you can select as no. And for the assessments happening in TCS ION centers, now there is this point that all the hands-on based assessments will take place at TCS office and all the MCQ assessment will happen in TCS ION centers. MCQ assessments like your non-technical tracks, so all those contains only the MCQ questions, so all of them will happen in your TCS ION centers, wherein you will not be allowed to take your system. You will be getting the systems from their end. Okay, so enough of the information. Now let's see how can you register for it. So I have already submitted it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to edit the response and show you how can you select it. So do you wish to take up the Wings 1 May assessment? You should definitely select yes, because if you select no, then you are clearly mentioning that you are not interested in attending the exam. Do you have TCS ID card with you? Make sure that you select yes. Even though if you do not have it, make sure to select yes and apply for the ID card and collect the ID card as soon as possible. Just in case if you do not know how to apply for ID card, I have already created a video in for this purpose, how to apply and get TCS ID card. Make sure to check that video and get your ID card. Do you have a TCS laptop with you? So you have to select either yes or no according to you. Okay, so next is your first core full stack track. So in the first core full stack track, there are different 9 tracks, okay, that you need to select. Suppose if you are selecting track T1, then in the second one also, if you are selecting core full stack track, then make sure that you do not select T1, because you cannot select the same track in both the cycles, both the steps, okay, step first and step second. Next point to remember is, if you are selecting track 7 in first, you cannot select track 7 or track 9 both in the second step. So you have, if you are selecting track 7 in the first, you have to select any one from T1 to T5, okay. The similar is the case with T9 also. So if you are selecting T9 in the first, you cannot select T7 or T9 in the second. You have to select any one from T1 to T5. Okay, so now many of you might have this doubt that I have not prepared for this core full stack track. Whether is it compulsory for me to attempt or select or register for this tracks or not? So it is, there is no compulsion as such. If you want, if you do not want to select it, you can totally skip these two. That is the track for full stack tracks. Okay, but my suggestion is, the more exams or the more registrations that you do, like for example, if you are registering for full stack track and also if you are registering for non-technical tracks, then the probability of you getting clearing the exam increases. That is the only reason that the associate selects more and more exams. Okay, otherwise if you have not prepared, it is totally upon you. You can totally skip this full stack tracks. Okay, so once you have selected the full stack tracks, the next is your business skill track, which is for step 2. So in business skill, you have to select any one track, either 1 or 2. So suppose if you have selected 2, you also have the option to select for other non-technical tracks like articulation and process. So again, it is your option. If you are willing to appear for these exams, you can, because as more and more you appear for the exams, the probability of getting the exams cleared increases. So that is why you can select both of these or any one of these or none of these according to you. Next is core programming tag. So if you are willing to attend core programming tag in either step 1 or step 2, what you need to do is you need to select the exam or the technology that you are willing to take the exam in. So for example, if you are willing to take it in Java, you can select Java. And after that, this one is not for the digital candidates, this is for innovators, so you do not have to select anything from this. So once you have selected everything according to your choice, you have to finally click on submit and your preference will be submitted. Okay, so again, I'll repeat some of the important points. Suppose if you have not prepared for full stack and you do not want to appear for full stack, what you will select? You will not select anything from this section, that is T1 to T9. You will not select anything from this section again. What you will do is you will select any one non-technical track from any of these, like any business skill track or articulation or process. You will select one of these or multiple of these according to you, and in the step 2 you will select, like in the other step you will select any one core programming tag. So in any way you have to select more than 2 or 2, okay, two you have to select for 2 exams. First is your core programming tag and second is your non-technical track if you are not willing to go for core full stack track. I hope I have cleared in a detailed manner. Just in case if you are still having more doubts, let me know in the comment section, and I want to let you know that there is already a video which I have created 1 month back based on this TCS Wings 1 Ninja to Digital Upgrade. In this I have explained in a more clear way, like how can you clear this exam, and also there are many comments on this video that you can see, around 135 comments, and I'm very sure that your doubt, the doubt that you are having, will almost be covered in the comment section of this video. Just in case if it is still not covered, make sure to comment in the current video that I am creating. So make sure to check the comment section of this video. I am very sure that your doubt was already covered by someone else, so make sure to check this. Okay, so you might have many doubts, like where to know our unit TD, if you are willing to upload external certification. So you can get all the paths and all the persons from this comment section. So with this I have come to an end of this video. Just in case if you have any more doubts and you are not getting a reply on the YouTube comment section, you can even DM me on Instagram. This is my Instagram page. Make sure to follow me on Instagram as well. So thanks for watching the video. See you in next video.